r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. Victims of sleep paralysis. What was your run-in with the sleep paralysis demon like? I get this on a regular basis. But mostly when I nap. Not when I go to sleep for the night. I have never experienced the demon. But the experience is terrifying. I can see everything, or at least it seems like I can, but I am unable to move. It feels like if I don't make every effort to move, I will be stuck like that forever. I usually have to start by wiggling a toe or a finger and then keep that momentum going until I fully wake. It takes an extreme amount of effort, and if I don't keep the effort constant, I have to start all over again. Yeah, that's the same for me too. The feeling is usually accompanied by a fear of closing my eyes or falling back asleep. This is exactly like my experiences. Only during sleep at odd times of the day. And I never experienced a demon. It's happened about a half dozen times now. And now that I can identify it when it's happening, I no longer struggle and panic. I just force myself to stay calm and go back to sleep. I've only experienced it 3 times, but my first time was the worst. I've never had any visual encounters, but when it happened the first time, I was laying on my left side and started to feel that pressure on my chest. When I realized I was paralyzed and started panicking, something whispered in my ear just coming in to say goodnight. That's when I felt like something was pushing me towards the edge of my bed. Terrifying shit. Same here. No visual encounters. I don't panic anymore as I'm used to it. It's just a bit annoying and unnerving. I had the auditory thing once. Freaked the hell out of me. It's a good thing I understand the causes of sleep paralysis, or else I'd be a mess. Don't just keep that knowledge to yourself. Share that crap. I've had 3 sleep paralysis events in my life. I saw a cat-sized shadow creature at the base of my bed, and it slowly crawled up onto my sheets and finally up to my chest. I felt uncomfortable. Another time I saw a shadow man walking around my room, disappearing behind my open door. This was the scariest one I've had so far. This one was the best. I saw a couple of surreal-looking penguins walking around my bedroom. It was amusing and funny. I like the penguins one. Describe it more in detail if you please. To take the edge off this damn thread. That's all it was. A bunch of retro 3D penguins walking around. It's just a feeling that something is there but not visible. I am paralyzed and get the sense that something is just out of sight. Maybe not the best description, but it is a really awful thing to experience. I actually have it fairly often. So much now that I realize when it's occurring. These days I just close my eyes and won't open them no matter what I feel or hear. Doing this though doesn't force me to wake up, and I still have to wait for it to end. I still feel and hear everything. Sometimes I feel like I'm being dragged somewhere, or just constantly feel like something is touching me along with muffled voices. Before I learned to cope with it, I've seen quite a few awful things. Horror films don't really do anything for me anymore because I've already seen the most terrifying things I already could. Here's a few things I remember off the top of my head. A little girl in the corner of my room staring at me. Then, without notice, she shrieks and runs up and starts choking me. A large dark figure, kind of a human silhouette, emerging from the foot of my bed and staring down at me. Something banging and scraping on my bedroom door. I keep it locked at night because I have had ones where it opens by itself. Edit. No. The door isn't open when I wake up. It only opens in the dream. My bedroom door opening by itself, followed by dark figures coming into my room. The earliest one I can remember is with my mother in the room, and she's sitting on my bed. Her face morphs into a demon-like thing. Many others. I feel like reading this thread is giving my subconscious more ideas for sleep paralysis episodes. I am not going to sleep well tonight. Lol. I hate myself more the further I read. Never had sleep paralysis. But if I woke up to that demon girl, literal bricks would be shat and I wouldn't sleep for days. Tonight is going to be fun. Good luck to you. I've had cycles of sleep paralysis for as long as I can remember, and regularly see 2 different demons. The hallucinations are visual, auditory, and you can physically feel them at times. They have become more vivid as I've gotten older. One is a tall, dark hooded figure that always stood at the bottom of my bed. My scariest experience with him was when I woke up one night with sleep paralysis and the big spooky hooded bastard was standing right next to me. His hood was covering his face, but I knew he was watching me and I knew he was evil. The second one I see is a smallish gremlin type creature that's got pointy features and is a browny green color, very similar to the one in the painting, but I had seen him before I had seen the painting or even knew what sleep paralysis was. He normally appears when I'm on my back and restricts my breathing and speaks in a weird whispery language. I woke up once and he was crouching in the corner of the ceiling. When I looked at him, he turned his head and looked right at me and smiled. I woke up on my side once and I could hear him behind me, speaking in his freaky language, and then I felt his snake-like tongue going in my ear and making a slithery noise. I can't tell how glad I am when I found out that there was a scientific explanation for it and that I wasn't actually being haunted. TL. Doctor brains are spooky assholes. This was my experience too. I knew the figures were evil, even if they didn't say or do anything. That feeling when you realize it's sleep paralysis and not demons. Yeah. Complete relief. People don't get how real these things seem. Some people use religion to comfort themselves about death. People that experience sleep paralysis use science to comfort themselves about life. Something like this. I haven't had one for a while now, but when I was 18 I had them 3 nights in a row. I couldn't sleep for days. Oh hell no, I'm not clicking on that. Can someone describe it to me and I shall grant you an upvote. It's a picture of an ordinary bedroom with the silhouette of a tall skinny humanoid in front of the bed. I haven't experienced sleep paralysis personally, but I've seen this GIF described as being similar to it. Edit. Well, I'd just like to say that it's been thoroughly entertaining to watch the reactions come in. Thank you all and everyone. And sorry, I guess. : That ending was significantly less terrifying than I was expecting. Little dude just came for a giggle. Sleep paralysis is, without a doubt, the scariest shit I have ever experienced and will likely ever experience. That feeling when you're convinced there's something standing over you while you're trying with every fiber of your being to move any muscle is truly terrifying. I remember waking up wailing incoherently the first time I experienced it. Pretty much like this. Yes. That is exactly what it is like. I had the sudden urge to wake up one night. And as much as I tried to open my eyes, I couldn't. Couldn't move my body and I could only get my eyes open for about a split second. Each time I opened them, I could see a figure getting closer and closer to my bed. Until I think I woke myself up out of fear, as I don't remember what happened after it got about 2 feet away from me. I was 16 when it happened to me and I had no clue what it was, so for a few weeks I was convinced that the house was haunted. I did not sleep well. Or without a light on. It wasn't until I told my mum about it that she said it sounded like sleep paralysis. Edit. I just remembered another case. It was not as scary, but it was weird. I went to bed one night and it was when I was falling asleep. I could hear children giggling outside the window and in the room. It was 11 p.m. Then out of nowhere in my ear I hear whispered, "Wake up. Wake up, Jokerki. You have to wake up." The incubus one is certainly an experience which will never leave my nightmares though. Ugh. I've gotten mine so frequently that I don't even freak out about it anymore. It's still scary, but not nearly as much as it used to be. The first few hallucinations were awful. A little creature eating something on my floor. I blink. Now he's right next to my face chewing on something and whispers, "Remember me?" An old lady standing over my head and whispers, "Darling." I told my mom about that one and she asked if I thought it was my late grandma. No. It was evil. The hallucinations are always evil. Even if I can't see anything, there is an overwhelming presence in the room and it is always evil. I can't move. I'm stuck. The evil is pulling on me deeper and deeper. I can't cry for help. I can only breath heavily as fast as I can, hoping someone will hear me breathing so loud and will come shake me out of it. I try and move a finger. Come on, finger. Why won't you just move? It's going to get me. Nowadays, I'm better at realizing what's going on and I have a routine to get out of it as quickly as I can. I breathe as fast and heavy as I can because that seems to be the only thing I can control. Sometimes I breathe so hard I start making guttural sounds in my throat. Shortly after that I'll manage to move something and slowly come out of it. Once I know for sure I'm out I must sit up in bed or stand up. If I fall back asleep, which is incredibly tempting to do, because the experience leaves me feeling exhausted, I'll cycle through 2 or 3 more episodes. Sometimes, I'll give up the fight and stop resisting. That's scary. I've never fully let go. The closest I've gotten to resisting the sleep paralysis felt like I was standing on the edge of hell and unless I tried to turn around I was going to fall in it. I don't ever try to do any lucid dreaming and I stay as far away from that as I can. I don't want to screw up my sleep any more than it already is. I have a few different sleep paralysis demons and one sort of sleep paralysis guardian angel. The demon ones are the usual shadowy figure standing over me or by my bedroom door. The worst one was while I was lying on my side with my back to the door and it felt like someone got into bed behind me, under the covers and put their arm round my waist. Then it felt like they were cuddling into me and I could feel breath on my neck. It felt like they cuddled me for about half an hour. All this time I'm trying not to show that I'm panicking because it feels like I'm getting cuddled by a skeleton with claws. It was only about the second, maybe third time I'd had sleep paralysis. So I nearly had a heart attack when this thing feels like it's moving in closer to kiss me behind the ear. Worst of all it whispered, "Not yet. You're not ready yet. I'll come back when you are." To me it sounded disappointed and excited. It felt like it was silently telling me it meant that it was coming back when I was about to die. Scared the ducking shit out of me. My sleep paralysis guardian angel was a weird experience. I'd been getting sleep paralysis on and off for about 18 months by this point, so I could usually tell straight away when it was happening. At first I thought it was the usual demon things beside my bed. But when I looked properly I realized I could clearly see a man kneeling next to my bed smiling at me. It wasn't a creepy smile. More like a parent coming in to check on their kid. He looked like he was dressed in a 50s style suit and hat. He didn't say anything. Although I got the sense he was letting me know everything was alright and he'd look after me. The strangest thing about my sleep paralysis guardian angel was that I felt like I knew him. Almost like when you see a relative you were around a lot while you were really young and then didn't see for years. If that makes sense. I only ever hear about people seeing the demon things. I've always wondered if anyone else has seen any guardian angels type things as well. My mom once told me that when she was younger, her room lit up and a couple of men dressed in white and gold were sitting at the foot of her bed playing music. One had a guitar and the other some kind of wind instrument. My mom said she felt such joy and peace that she didn't want them to ever go. But when she finally managed to move her head, she heard one say to the other, "She is waking up. It's time for us to go." Then they vanished. TLDR. Mom was serenaded by angels. I'm imagining a mariachi band. I'm typing this quick at work. I apologize for any errors. I get to see mine about once a month. Usually somewhere near the full moon, which is odd. It starts out usually with me waking up. I can always tell what is about to happen, so I try to scream and wake someone up to shake me out of it. If that does not work, I try to move my limbs and force myself to roll out of bed and wake up. This typically does not work, so I know it's time for the visit. A shadow forms along the floorboards of my bedroom and starts going up the walls. I can then feel the presence of radio TV static. This shadow starts to form into a demon similar to the early renditions of Slender Man. He has no eyes or face, just little balls of static where the facial structure should be. He slowly starts edging closer and closer to my face and the volume of the static rises and I can feel it very lightly shocking me. It then puts me in some weird trance by grabbing the sides of my face and screaming directly into it. This is the scariest part. The scream is so shrill I can't even describe to you how terrible it is. As this happens the room starts to turn red and these giant arms start to form into long spikes. So while I'm stunned hypnotized it starts taunting me with the spikes, rubbing them around my neck and heart etc. He then reaches up and stabs me directly into the throat and I wake up. I apologize again for the sloppy typing. If enough people are interested I'll post a painting I did of it and fill you in about 3 other ones I get once in a while. editimga.com link. I'd love to see the painting. That sounds scary as duck. I want to see the painting. My girlfriend has this and it happens once every few months. She says she sees shadows walking around or crawling on the wall toward her. But she can't move or scream. But she knows I'm there and can even tell me what I was doing while she was laying there paralyzed. She can sometimes tell me what I was looking at or that I was petting the cat. It's creepy and scary. But there's no way of me knowing it's happening till after it's over. I have been having bouts of sleep paralysis since I was 16. It usually goes like this. I wake up from a light sleep. Sometimes my eyes are open and sometimes not. I am aware of my surroundings and I can hear whatever is happening. But I cannot move. By pure force of will, I am able to slightly move my head. If I begin to think about my breath, I usually start to panic because it is very hard to control. On a rare occasion, I will hallucinate while paralyzed. This usually involves a feeling or sound. I once heard the front door open and a cat meow. I then felt the cat jump onto the bed and rub its fur on my arm. I had no cat. The act of breaking the sleep paralysis feels like a battle of willpower. It is like trying to break free of a force that is holding you still. Each attempt is exhausting. It will usually take 4 or 5 tries and after each try I feel myself sink a bit back into myself. It's like backing up to get a run at trying to break through a door. I push and push until I can't anymore. Eventually I push through and wake up all the way. Sometimes after I wake up I have a cloudy mind for hours afterwards. On a real bad night I may have half a dozen or more bouts of sleep paralysis. I have developed techniques for dealing with it. Sleeping on my side is the best deterrent. If I can keep from getting panics about breathing, then I am sometimes able to ignore it altogether and just fall back to sleep. This has been a great source of some awesome lucid dreaming. I have been dealing with it for 22 years now. You may find it comforting to know that not once have I been permanently paralyzed, obviously. I've always been able to get up and suffered little more than just being scared. You know how sometimes when you're leaving a room and you turn the light off, you suddenly feel like you're being chased and you need to run the fig off? It's that feeling all over again, son, the running bit. Drenches you in cold sweat and sometimes a little urine too. I always go to the bathroom before bed though. Since I'm a natural lucid dreamer and do sometimes get stuck in a sleep paralysis. Old lady sitting on my chest telepathically telling me I'm going to die and she wanted to watch but she wasn't going to do it. Pretty much. Moment after moment of endless terror that someone was in the room watching me and plotting. Then I flew through space at the speed of infinity. Edit. That little guy on her stomach looks exactly like a masculine version of the old hag I see. Upload Wikimedia org link. I find the horse creepier. The demon looks like a grumpy demon. Hahaha, like he got sit on people duty and not like torture duty. It has only happened once to me and it scared the shit out of me. I was taking a quick nap while my 2-year-old was napping. I woke up to hearing someone open my front door and walk in. They steps came to my door and I saw it open out of the corner of my eye. The whole time I could not move or blink. It stood there for a bit and then closed the door and went to my son's room. That's when I really panicked and it was done. I could get up and my heart was racing. Threw me for a ducking loop. I used to have sleep paralysis up to 10 times a night. Most nights at one point. I would wake up with that familiar feeling of buzzing or vibrating in my head. I would see flashed at light. That sense of dread and pending doom scared the shit out of me. I would even hear what sounded like English being said backwards. And obviously. Paralysis. Same. I absolutely cannot fall asleep on my back or sleep paralysis is pretty much inevitable. But side note. Have you ever woken up? Gotten out of bed? Started your day only to realize you're actually still stuck in your bed? I think it's called false awakening. Sometimes it repeats over and over until you actually wake up. That is the worst. I had totally forgotten about this until you mentioned it. I had those false awakenings nearly every night when I was a teenager. Got to the point where I couldn't tell if conversations were real or dream conversations and I was constantly confusing people. This thread has sort of inspired me. So enjoy an amateur sketch of your descriptions of sleep paralysis. imga.com link. I have sleep paralysis and related parasomnias fairly regularly. Sometimes they're simple. A recent one that comes to mind involved feeling something moving just behind my back, which was very unsettling. My most coherent sleep paralysis memory concerning an evil presence involved me first listening in on what seemed to be someone else's thoughts, only to have them sense my presence and start choking me telepathically. Unfortunately, I don't have anything visually spectacular to recount. Usually I'll hear evil voices or laughter and feel things touching me. It doesn't frighten me much these days, but it will cause me to wake up out of sheer annoyance. It's gotten to the point where I start to get legitimately annoyed by it happening, to the point that I'm often thinking, oh god, not this shit again. Now I actually have to lift 350 kilograms with my arm again to get out of it. Thing is that the paralysis would just recur until I finally decide to sit up for a minute. Because if I don't, sometimes I'm way too tired to even do that, I would get paralyzed every time falling asleep. Infinitely. I've been to the point of around 12 times of this happening in a row. Generally, I force myself to fall asleep facing my wall in case it happens to me, so I just have to deal with snapping out of it instead of weird presences. I've tried to just let it happen a few times, as I'm very aware of what's happening as soon as it happens and what I'd need to do to fight it. Thing is that if I don't fight the paralysis, I feel like falling into a hole where sound and vision becomes bizarre and loud, probably the most disturbing part for me personally. I also tend to get a weird tingle in the back of my head upon moving my eyes to the far left right after actually waking up. Only after sleep paralysis. Never realized this is what I had experienced until I started looking around here. Worst experience I had was with a devil-like creature. Red and black with huge teeth that sat on me. It felt like it was suffocating me. It just kept pushing on my chest and I was terrified. I couldn't move or scream. What made it really bad was after I got up, my husband woke up startled and told me something had been pressing on his chest trying to kill him. TLDR. Both me and my husband had sleep paralysis at same time with devil demons sitting on our chests. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.